weren't doing anything sophisticated, really. We're just looking at conversion from hexadecimal to, I believe we ended at stage where we're looking at conversion from hexadecimal to binary. But we also looked at conversion from binary to hexadecimal, really. We realized that the best approach for doing the conversion is to group the binary, like when you are converting from either from hexadecimal to binary or binary hexadecimal, is you group your binary digits into groups of fours, right? So-called nibbles or half a byte, really. And we looked at some examples. We mostly used the example associated with the status of Lighton's QT spin, right? So if you remember, the conversion that Lighton was using is this, right? So if I open up my QT spin, the status of the registers is shown to me. So we were using these things here to do the conversion, right? I did mention that we would continue off our conversation by really looking at some of the examples that we have here, hopefully to reinforce the discussion we started yesterday, and perhaps try and see if people have any specific questions associated to this, right? So we're just going to skim through some examples of conversion from hexadecimal to binary, right? Starting with A to DE, right? Again, for most of these conversions, and in fact, most of the things we're going to cover in ICT 1110, including these other courses we're going to be looking at, things like 2010 next year, for instance, 2021, I'm not sure about 2022. It turns out that everything is just centered around rules and conventions, right? Rules. So in this case, I guess what I'm trying to say is, if you want this to work, you just have to make sure that you follow the rules, right? And of course, you don't have to follow the rules that Lighton is laying out as we are interacting together. It's entirely possible that you might find other rules online somewhere out there, perhaps a much easier to work with method, right, for doing this computation. That's fine, as long as you stick to it. Let's follow the rules. So converting A to DE base 16 into base 2, for instance, we are saying the first thing we need to do is we convert these hexadecimal symbols into their equivalent decimal symbols. Now, this example here is pretty interesting because we have three of the four symbols are symbols that are not associated with the 10 decimal symbols that we normally work with. And so what do? We need to identify the corresponding decimal equivalents. So A is 10, 2 of course is still going to be 2, D is 13, E is 14. And then using these decimal numbers, we convert to binary using 4-bit representation. Right? So whatever answers we're getting as we're converting these decimal numbers here, 10, 2, 13, and 14 into binary, we have to use 4-bit representation. If your answer only has one digit, one binary digit, you prepend it, or you prefix it with 3 zeros so that it's represented using 4-bit representation. And finally, the final stage is just group those nibbles together, right? So 10 is 1010, right? This is obvious. We're just adding 8 plus 2, right? 8 plus 2. 1's place, 2's place, 4's place, 3's place. So 1's place, 2's place, 4's place, 8's place, right? So 8 plus 2. 1's place, 2's place, 4's place, 8's place. So we're adding 8 plus 2 to get 10. 2 is just 0, 1, right? And then 13 is 1101, 14 is 1110, right? And you can confirm this, you can verify these later on. As you are doing this for the first time, I do encourage you to follow the rules we laid out when you're doing a conversion from decimal to binary, right? Because this is what we're doing in the third step here, yeah? For us to get from 14 to 110, we went through our simple heuristic. What is our simple heuristic? We repeatedly divide 14 by 2 until we converge, when the result is going to be 0, right? I know for those of you that have already figured this out, that's fine, but we want to make sure we're on the same page here. So it's in decimal to binary 14, repeatedly divided by 2, where you have the result, quotient, and the remainder, right? 2 into 14 is 7, remainder 0, 2 into 7 is 3, remainder 1, 2 into 3 is 1, remainder 1, 2 into 1 is 0, remainder 1, right? Our answer is 1, 1, 1, 0, right? Because we need to flip these. So we have 1, 1, 1, 0. If we were to look at an example that has resulting bits that are less than 4, like this here, we repeatedly divide 2 by 2, right? This is the quotient, this is the result. 2 into 2 is 1, remainder 0. 2 into 1 is 0, remainder 1. What is the answer? 1, 0. Because the answer is 1, 0, the next step will involve us making sure that all of these answers are represented using 4-bit representation, right? So observe this thing here. Instead of 1, 0, we are saying it's going to be 0, 0, 1, 0, right? And then finally, we know that the answer is going to be derived by combining all of these different nibbles or groups of fours here into one thing. And then this is the answer here. Now observe something, right? If we did not prefix or prepend this 1 0 with the 2 zeros, our answer was going to be, it was going to be wrong, right? Observe this. This is an important point, I guess. I don't know if you pay attention to what I'm doing here, but if I copy this, what's going on here, but and paste, okay. And what we're saying, right, is if you don't prefix, this is the answer here, right? And you can confirm this, right? This is the answer, you can confirm this with your calculator. But assuming that we missed out the third step here, where if we missed out this step here, where we made sure that all the resulting solutions are represented using 4-bit representation, would have ended up with an answer that is similar to this here. Observe. This would have been our answer. No zeros here. This would have been our answer. And guess what? If you convert this, if you use your calculator and convert this to hexadecimal from binary, what you will realize is that the answer you will get is going to be different. It's 2ADE, right? So this is equal to 2ADE. When in actual fact, the answer is supposed to be A2DE, right? This is A2DE, but what we got when we did not prefix with the zeros was 2ADE, right? And we can confirm also with the calculator here, right? So you want to be very careful that you follow the rules, right? And you'd get this wrong if you just omitted this part here. Is this making sense?
Sir, do you mind going over it just one more time?
Yeah, well, so we have another example here, but I don't know which part I can go. Yeah, sure, I don't mind going over it again. It's a pretty...
Just this example, that's all. Just this part, that's all.
Yeah, I mean... So what we're saying is the rules are simple, right? First step, when you have a hexadecimal number, like A2DE, even if it was 22 in a hexadecimal, the first step is you lay out the hexadecimal symbols one after the other as they appear left to right. The next step is you convert each individual hexadecimal symbol in its equivalent decimal symbol. A is 10. 2 is 2, D is 13, E is 14. And then the third step is you're going to convert these decimal symbols now, because these are hexadecimals, decimal symbols. You convert the decimal symbols into their equivalent binary numbers. Converting them to binary is easy. You repeatedly divide each one of these decimal symbols by 2. Right, so Repeat it, divide by two until you converge to a stage where the result is zero. And then you lay out the bits one after the other. So if we repeatedly divide 10 by 2, we get 1010. We repeatedly divide 2 by 2, we get 10. We repeatedly divide 13 by 2, we get 1101. We repeatedly divide 14 by 2, we get 1110. The next step is we want to ensure that the binary results here are all represented using 4-bit representation. You must have 4 bits. If you have any result that does not have 4 bits, as is the case for 10 here, what you must do is you prefix or you prepend it with zeros at the beginning until you have 4 bits representing that number. So instead of, so 1010 will be 1010, 10 will be 0010, 4-bit representation. 1101 will be 1101, 1110 will be 1110. The key thing here is you must represent the final result, each of the individual symbols that you've converted using 4-bit representation. Otherwise, you'll get the wrong answer. You'll be quite sad, really. I don't know. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I don't know how many people we have in the house, but wow. 15. Such sadness. Anyways,